October 16th, 1968. With the world watching, U.S. Olympic runners Tommy Smith and John Carlos raised their fist into the air to protest inequity against African Americans. The historic moment unfolded on the medal stand at the Mexico City Olympics, a period of tremendous strife in America.
It was occurring at a time in which there's a great deal of tension and a great deal of uncertainty about how to conduct ourselves in the same summer following the assassination of Martin Luther King, the assassination of Senator Bobby Kennedy.
Smith capturing the gold medal had just broken the world record in the 200-meter race. Carlos won the bronze. At the medal stand, the pair stood shoeless to symbolize poverty and wore beads to represent lynching victims. As the Star-Spangled Banner played, they bowed their heads and raised their fist in protest. American University race, media, and communication professor Sherry Williams says it was an act of courage and bravery.
So to have these two young black men take this moment that was really amplified across the globe and particularly here in this country and to use it to bring attention to the black liberation struggle was very, very significant.
After the 1968 medal ceremony, the U.S. Olympic team suspended the men and sent them home. But at a recent event in Washington, D.C., the pair was hailed as heroes.
Free expressions must be a continuous sound, my people, through education, because overcoming is not a dead issue. In the face of adversity, the struggle continues.
In September, Carlos returned to Mexico City to mark the anniversary of the defiant moment 50 years ago. He used the occasion to remind others that every person can make a difference.
Doing the right thing is not an easy thing to do for me or anyone else. I stood there 50 years ago in the podium where one guy had his fist up with me and another guy stood there in support of me. But 50 years of that poster being there, we three cannot change society to make it better without the help of you.
Inevitably, there are modern-day comparisons to the current U.S. controversy over NFL players kneeling during the national anthem and other protests against police brutality. The Mexico City moment is considered an inspiration.
Right now in 2018, 50 years old, there are still individuals who sort of are protest-oriented, who look to that time for clues on how to conduct themselves now. And that just speaks to the lasting power of that moment.
We see that when athletes do stand up and step up, that it really does make a difference and it causes systemic change. And that's what Tommy Smith and John Carlos were trying to do in 1968. That's what Colin Kaepernick is trying to do today.
With their common bond of breaking barriers, Smith and Kaepernick made it a point to meet in person last fall, two men who put fighting racial injustice ahead of their own athletic careers. Mariama Diallo, VOA News, Washington.